Good afternoon, HS, and welcome to the BTV Announcement Show. I'm Jane.
And I'm Ella. It's weird for me to say, but today is Wednesday, and it's the end of the week. I kind of like the sound of that.
Yes. Last day of school for us as we get the next couple days off for parent-teacher conferences. Sorry you still have to be here, teachers, but we'll be thinking about you while we're sleeping in.
The four-day weekend will give us a good chance to rest up for winter sports tryouts that are starting on Monday. And then, it's back to a regular full week of school the rest of the week.
Today on the show, we'll show you the pictures of the Halloween door decorating contest and announce the winning door. We had about 20 entries, and it was tough, but we have a winner.
All that, plus a shout-out to the October birthdays, and it's all coming up right after our very short list of announcements.
Attention French Club members. There will be a meeting today after school in room 225 North.
The next Environmental Vikings Club meeting will be Wednesday, November 10th at 310 in room 830. New members are welcome.
Attention seniors, have you finally written your college essay or personal statement? Want to show it off for a cash prize? Submit your essay today. Use Google Classroom code RWO25CZ for rules and guidelines. See Mrs. Mustafa in A11 for more information. The deadline is December 1st at midnight.
The speech team opened its competition season at home, hosting the Age of Viking Halloween Classic. In our novice division for first-time competitors, HF took a third-place finish among 23 attending schools. Special congratulations to Rachel Griggs, who did exceptional work, earning straight ones and becoming our tournament champion.
Congratulations to the varsity chess team for winning their conference match on Tuesday, November 2nd. The team defeated Bradley-Bourbonnais High School with a score of 56-12. Sam Starkenberg, Christian Tate, Eric Nickerson, Lyndon Proby, Eli Burr, Everett Van Til and Joshua Bray had impressive victories. The team will play at home when they face Bolingbrook next Tuesday.
Anyone who is interested in wrestling should come to an informational meeting in the North Wade classroom tomorrow at 3:30 p.m. No experience necessary, and boys, girls, and managers are encouraged to come.
Open off-season training for track and field will last the remainder of the time until our season officially begins on January 18th. Mondays and Thursdays are in the weight room. Wednesdays are on the indoor track. Training will run from 3:20 to 4. These open training days are completely optional. Any questions, please see Coach Beebe in room G3.
There will be a two-day tryout for all who are interested in trying out for girls gymnastics on Monday, November 8th and Tuesday, November 9th in the North Gymnastics Gym from 3:20 to 6. You must be present for both days. Make sure you are registered and have a current physical turned in to the athletic office before tryouts. Come see Coach May in A27 or Coach Chapel in E6 if you have any questions.
Speaking of gymnastics, they really want to get a good turnout for tryouts on Monday and created this video for those interested.
Does the idea of being on a successful gymnastics team interest you? If so, the HF Gymnastics team is a team for you. Gymnastics is a unique sport that requires grace and elegance, but also is challenging.
You might have to do some jumps and leaps using that grace and elegance. But you also have to tumble, and you have to do really challenging skills that require a lot of strength.
After attending only 7 meets, winning 2 of them, and placing 3rd in the entire conference, the program is ready to get back going.
I think they're all really excited to have a full season. Like I said, you know, we missed out on a lot of invites last year, and those are some of the meets where we get to see schools that we don't normally get to compete against.
With feelings high, the team is ready to continue what they started last season.
If you're interested in trying out, we'll be in the North Gym in the second floor from 3:20 to 6 o'clock next Monday and next Tuesday.
For VTV, I'm Ian Horth.
The fall sports season is winding down, and I believe cross country is the only sport still competing as our two finalists go to state this weekend.
We thought it would be a good idea to sum up the fall sports seasons as our guys in sports wrap up each team's year.
The boys' soccer team finished the regular season with a record of 6-9, but unfortunately they lost in the first round of the regional tournament.
The HF girls' field hockey team had a record of 0-11 this year. Their last loss came to Loyola Academy on October 27th with a score of 7-1.
The girls' tennis team finished with a season record of 11-10-1. The doubles team of junior Amina Kendrick and freshman Brooklyn Aldridge qualified for state. Girls volleyball team finished with a season record of 16-18 and lost in regionals to Bolingbrook.
The football finished the season 4-5 and missed the playoff for the first time in many years. Justin Thomas, Miles Walton, Donovan Caesar, and Malik Jones all got all-conference honors. The boys golf team finished with a 6-8 record and a third overall finish at the Glendale Lakes 15-team tournament. Three advanced to the sectional championship. Cameron Reed, Charlie Van Etten, and Tyler Thompson did it. Reed was the only state qualifier.
The girls' golf team finished their season 0-9, but did advance to the sectional championship during their playoff run.
Thanks, guys, and congrats to all the fall sports teams on a great season.
A few weeks ago, we asked you to let us know if you want VTV to recognize you on your birthday. A few people filled out our form, and today we recognize those October birthdays.
Those audio difficulties, but happy birthday to all of you. We hope you had a special day. And if you want your birthday to be recognized on VTV, make sure you check your Google Classroom announcements page for the link to turn that in.
Okay, let's talk about door decorating. We offered up a nice Halloween treat to any class that could decorate their door and make it look spooky and nice.
The only rules were you had to include a pumpkin somewhere in the design, and the only thing that could be decorated was the actual door, not the surrounding walls or ceilings.
We had a number of entries, so here they are in no particular order. Take a look. Now, let's get to the winner. We have a bag full of Halloween goodies for the class that went all out with a great theme this year.
Congratulations to Mrs. Lewis's class. Great job on the door. Very spooky and very professional at the same time.
We'll be sending your treats to you guys during your next Compass class on Monday.
Okay, that concludes today's show. We thank you for tuning in and hope you guys have a great 4-day weekend. For everyone here at VTV, I'm Ella.
And I'm Jane. Have a great day, HF.